Hey, it's John with Vision Advisors. Let me encourage you. Matter of fact, let me caution you. Don't send in your next app yet until you make sure that you're compliant with the new rules. Now, what am I saying? Before you send in your next annuity application or your life case for that matter, you need to make sure that you are being fully compliant with the new suitability standards and rules that are being implemented by carriers across the country. Let me explain what's happening and why. Many of you may remember from a earlier Insight broadcast that I shared that the NAIC passed recently the annuity sales law. Significant changes into how we as financial professionals engage in the sale of annuity products. The SEC has promulgated and released Reg BI, which has changed the way that the broker-dealer industry has had to operate, moving them from a suitability standard to more of a best interest standard, as does the annuity sales law. As a significant number of states have begun adopting these regulations, the insurance carriers have made a conscious decision that whether your state has adopted these rules or not, they are going to require this as the, quote, new normal for doing business with them going forward. So you need to grab a pen and paper, and you need to make sure that you write down the steps that are going to be required to make sure that you are compliant with the new rules and you don't get a surprise that you don't want to find under the Christmas tree. So what's going to be required going forward? Let me give you a quick checklist. Number one, and I think one of the most important things, and something you should be doing anyway, and that's the use of a fact finder. Going forward, it's going to be very important that you can evidence the fact that you know your client, that you have taken an opportunity to understand their wants, their needs. You've gathered basic information about their current financial situation, what they want their money to do for them, and the problems they want you to solve. A good fact finder can help you do that. And as part of the suitability process, quality review, or even post-review, the insurance carrier under these new regulations can require that you provide a written copy of a fact finder. Secondly, they can ask for and you should keep, and the rules require that you document every client conversation, either with an audio recording or handwritten notes about what you talked about, the different subject matters that you shared, making notes about what the client spoke to you about in relation to their wants, their needs, their concerns, their objections with maybe a current product or service that they're using that they're looking to change, and being able to evidence the conversation and where that conversation took you in the planning process. Thirdly, you're going to need to be able to have a written rationale, an explanation as to why the product recommendation that you are making is in the client's best interest. And if a replacement is involved, you need to be in that written rationale, you need to be able to document why this replacement is good for the client, what they are giving up versus what they're gaining. Now, there's a few other items that you're going to need to keep as well. In addition to what I mentioned on the previous slide, the fact finder, the conversation notes, the written rationale as to the reason why, and if there's a replacement involved, evidencing and documenting that, you're going to need to have a copy of the application and any and all supporting documentation that you use during the sales process. Maybe that's a copy of the brochure. Maybe you drew pictures on a white pad. All of that needs to be documented, supported, and saved so that in the event there is a question relating to this particular case during the suitability review, following suitability review in quality control, anytime during the free look period, or even after if there is a customer complaint, you have to be able to provide that information to the carrier upon demand. That's right. The carrier has the right at any time to demand that you provide this information, documentation, written, so that they can have an opportunity to review your notes and that you can validate the recommendation that you made. Another particular area that they're going to be looking at is monitoring the type of business that you're writing with a carrier. You know, many producers do a great job, but there are a handful of producers that I know here at Vision and other IMO friends that I have in the industry, that they have producers that only write one product, and they only write that one product for every single client. Well, we know that clients' wants and needs differ. So how can one product solve the same need or different needs for different clients over and over and over? This is a form of what we call bias-based selling. And this is something that insurance carriers are going to be monitoring more closely going forward. So as an example, if you only sell high compensation products and you're selling the highest comp products out there that benefit you but potentially harm the client or limit their opportunity for gains and future growth, that's going to be a problem going forward. If you only sell a bonus annuity because you believe that a bonus is the only way to go, there are times a bonus is great for a client. There's other times it's not. So making sure you're selling the right product is something that's important. Whether you sell income riders and you believe everybody should have an income rider or nobody should have an income rider, again, those are biases that they're going to be looking for. If a client has a need for income, then an income rider may make sense. If a client does not have a need for income and they're looking simply to grow the money, then an accumulation annuity makes sense. But the needs of the client are going to dictate the type of product that is sold. That's where the fact finder and all the corresponding notes and documentation come in to validate that recommendation going forward. So at the end of the day, how do we make sure we're being compliant? Let me give you the question you really need to think about. As you're sitting with your client, you need to objectively ask yourself this question. Given all the available options, including doing nothing and allowing the client to keep what they currently have, how is the recommendation that you're making, how is this transaction that you're proposing in the best interest of the client? You can't consider your compensation. You can't consider anything that benefits you. The question has to be focused to the benefit of the client. And at the end of the day, isn't that what we all want? We want to make sure that we're taking care of our clients. This is a way that we can weed out the few bad apples that remain in our industry so everyone else that's doing it right can continue not to have to deal with overregulation as a result of the few bad apples in the industry. Now, what happens if you fail to comply with this documentation requirement going forward? Now, here's a big one, and this one we're seeing a number of carriers begin to implement just in the last 30 to 60 days. The ability to engage in a chargeback action against the producer beyond the 30-day free look period. That's right. If a client makes a complaint or their beneficiaries make a complaint, maybe you sold something to the kids and now to the parents, and now the kids come in and look at the transaction and they start asking questions and they call the carrier. And the carrier demands the file from you that you've built on that client and you don't have it, you may be 2 years into the contract and they can now go back and charge back either in part or in whole your commission. Secondly, they have the option to terminate you if they find a pattern of behavior or gross negligence on your part in being able to provide, or this becomes something that they consistently see you doing that is problematic. There can also now, if you don't have the documentation and there's termination there, you could be sued by a client or a beneficiary under these new rules. So it's important to make sure that you're doing proper documentation to support what you're offering to the client. And if the state sees a pattern of noncompliance, the state reserves the right to revoke your license and you're out of the business. Now, that's the bad news, but I've got some good news on that. But first off, I want to challenge you. Don't let this be you. Don't just stick your head in the sand and think, I can do business the way I've always done it and nothing's going to happen to me. Well, whether we like it or not, the cheese has moved. Regulation is tightening. And as more carriers adopt this NAIC standard and adopt this Reg BI standard into how they conduct business, you're going to be forced to go there whether you want to or not. So why not make the move now? And I'm going to show you how you use these regulations as an ally to actually be able to do more business. And understand this, more regulation is coming. We're still seeing the Department of Labor look at rolling out their new DOL rule. They've enhanced it, they've changed it, but that is coming, and more states are adding their own requirements on top of that, again, making sure that consumer protection is forefront. So for some of you at this point, you may be going, oh my goodness, I don't know what to do. You want to just scream because it looks like it's getting increasingly more difficult to do business. But I'm here to tell you, it doesn't have to be that way. You can actually use these regulations and these new enhanced suitability requirements to your advantage. Okay, John, I'm listening. How in the world do you do that? You begin to alter the way you do your practice to engage in what we call consultative selling. Individuals that engage in consultative selling have an opportunity to sell more. They have an opportunity to sell more often, to sell bigger cases, to get more referrals, and ultimately get to the point in their practice that they can stop prospecting altogether. Now, doesn't that sound like fun? The opportunity to sell more, to sell more often, to sell bigger cases, to get more referrals, so you don't have to invest dollars in marketing because your clients become raving fans that bring you all of the business that you want and need and that you can handle. So now the big question you got rolling around in your head is, John, that sounds great. How in the world do I do that? Well, that's where we at Vision come in. We're going to be introducing in the month of October a new course in our Vision Sales Academy. And this is an opportunity for you to learn how to transition what you're doing to become more consultative in your practice. We're going to share with you Consultative Selling 101, what we call the ultimate sales success funnel. And we're going to show you in this training how you can build a sustainable marketing system that allows you to be able to grow your practice and get to the point that you're no longer having to invest in your marketing, but you'll have plenty of dollars available if you want to. Now, why would we do this? The question I want to share real quickly, and it's part of the study and the training that we do, looking at a study done by GKIC Marketing this year, looking back at the most successful people in the financial services industry, here's what they found. We looked at 100% of them in this sampling. 95% of them are what we would call mediocre, average, or only somewhat successful. Only 5% were highly successful. And only 1% were what I call super successful. But the goal in this consultative selling program is to find the individuals that are serious about adapting to the changes that have taken place in our industry because of COVID-19, and we're never going to go back to where we were before. Yesterday's normal is not today's normal, and tomorrow's normal is going to be different than today's. There's not a new normal. Normal changes as we move forward, but the goal of this training is to move you out of the 95% to move you into the 5%. You may say, John, I think I'm already highly successful. Well, that's great if you are, but let me ask you this. Do you have more quality prospects coming into your business than you can handle? Are you writing more apps than you have time to manage? If so, you may be highly successful. But for the bulk of you listening to this message and you look in the mirror and you're honest with yourself, you're going to find yourself and having to admit I'm part of the 95, and I'd love to get out of that rat trap. So what are we going to do? We're going to introduce four sessions that we're going to teach how to put together the right message, get that message to the right person at the right time, using the right marketing medium or mediums to get your message out there. Now, why is this important and why are these four things mission critical? Because understanding this is learning how the top 5% in our industry make more money than the entire 95% combined. That's right. The top 5% in the financial services industry earn more money than the bottom 95% combined. Now, who wants to be in that number? These are the creme de la creme. These are the best of the best. And we've had an opportunity to interview a number of them over the last several months to find out what they're doing. I've had an opportunity to work with direct marketing guru Dan Kennedy, who is one of the wizards of Wall Street when it comes to selling. And I had an opportunity in the month of August to spend 2 days with Dan Kennedy, getting insights and him sharing with me his insights into this consultative selling model. So my question for you is, are you interested? Would you like to learn more? If so, then let me ask you this, or let me say this. You know, if there is ever a time to try something new, it's now, when nothing else is working. Think about that. If you were doing dinner seminars, how many of you are back in a restaurant? Probably not many. You were going door to door, not able to do that right now. If you had people coming to your office, how many appointments do you have every day during the week? How many people are venturing back out of their house to come see you or allowing you to go see them? Nothing's working right now for the vast majority of financial professionals across the country. So if there is ever a time to try something new and to learn what the 5% are doing and doing well that the 95% either can't do or won't do, that's a challenge. You know, I spent a few days with Chris Robinson, who is the sales director for John Maxwell Enterprises. Chris is a friend and he lives in St. Louis. And he made a statement that I thought was amazing. And it challenged me and it rocked me to the core in my own personal profession. And he said this, he says, John, for every sales professional, he says, they have to come to the point in time that they realize it's not that they can't, it's that they won't. And that choice is theirs. So I'm looking for the folks that aren't willing to say, I won't and I can't, but I'm looking for the folks that are willing to say, I want to learn something new. I want to try something new. So my question for you is, would you invest one day in yourself? Would you give yourself one day to learn something new that could revolutionize your practice and move you to the point that you get out of the 95% and get into the selling habits and strategies and tactics that are used by the top 5% in their industry to help more clients, to make more money, and to live a better life? Or are you going to be content to stay in that 95% and live life there for the rest of your life? Not that you can't, but because you won't. And that choice is yours. So coming up in October, we're going to be doing a one-day event, 2 sessions in the morning, 2 sessions in the afternoon, and we're going to have an opportunity to teach this concept to you and to share with you the insights and secrets that the top 5% use in terms of their habits, their strategies, and their tactics to see incredible success. So if you're interested, I'd love to hear from you. 1-800-505-8489. Give me a call. Talk to Melissa. Talk to Gary. Any of the people on our sales consulting team, we would love to know that you're interested, and we'll get more information to you and give you an invite. This will be an interactive online workshop where we will be going through some training together. We will be working on a plan together. We will be interacting with each other in this workshop as we walk through and talk about this. And together, we're going to help you build out a success plan to improve your results in 2021, to give you a better tomorrow than you have today. And I think at the end of the day, that's what we all want. Now, if you've got questions about these new suitability rules, again, it's another reason to give us a call here at Vision Advisors and let us walk you through the process. If you don't have a fact finder, we've got an amazing fact finder that we can share with you that not only allows you to gather the important information you need, but it provides the thought-provoking questions that every good financial advisor should be using as conversation starters. After all, questions lead to answers. And if you're asking the right questions, you're going to get the right answers from your client. And if you allow your client to tell you what they have in terms of problems, now you know what problems to solve. And if we can do this correctly and help you build the information that you're going to need to keep going forward, you're going to be more compliant, you're going to be more successful, and you're going to see more opportunity than you've ever seen before. Hey, it's John Terry with Vision Advisors. Let me say thanks for joining me today. I look forward to helping you transition your practice, add to what you're doing now to elevate and increase your success as we move forward together. Have a great day.